All right, so here we go. Well, on A, you're going to cover up one of these, so I'll cover that one up. 10 divided by 4 is 2.5, so y is 2.5. Look at your work and make sure you have that. When I cover up the y, I get 10 divided by 2, so I get x equals 5. So I graph it real simple. So I go over 2.5, which is here, and then up 5. So 1, actually, let me back up. This was my y. My x is 5, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then up 2.5. So 1, 2, 3, 2.5 is right there. So, actually, I'm doing all this wrong, aren't I? These are intercepts, so it should be x equals 5 and y is 2.5. Now I got it. Okay, so it looks like this. My fault. I was graphing like slope. Any questions on how to do A? Is everybody clear on that? All right. I'll do one more, okay? Let's do the fraction. Well, this one, if I cover up the x, I get y equals 12. This one, if I cover up the y, I have to put a 0 right here. So put 0 is equal to 5 over 6x plus 12. You have to be able to solve this. So subtract 12. So you get a negative 12 is equal to 5 over 6x. Now you multiply by 6, which is going to be a negative 72. And then you're going to divide by 5. So I'm going to take 72 divided by 5, whatever that is. So 72 negative divided by 5. I get 14.4. So x is equal to a negative 14.4. So I graph it. Now watch how I do this one, okay? I know it's fractions, and nobody likes fractions. So I go, my y is 12, so I go all the way up to 12. And I'm not going to count it, so I'll just say 12. My x is a negative 14. That's way somewhere over here. So negative 14.4 is somewhere over there. Any questions on how to graph that fraction one? Yeah, I had to do some work on it, but oh well. So everybody clear? When you cover up that y, you got to put a 0. Now we got to graph this one. Okay, watch how I graph this one. I'm going to cover up the x. So I get y is negative 6. So I go down 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Put a dot. Now here comes my fraction again, so watch. If I cover up the y right here, I got to put a 0. So put 0 is equal to 4 over 3x minus 6. Draw a line, circle that. Now you have to be able to solve that. And some of you can. I mean, I listen to you. And I know some of you can do it. So I'm going to add 6 to both sides. So I get 6 is equal to 4 over 3x. I'm almost done, believe it or not. I multiply by 3. So 6 times 3 is 18 equals 4x. And then I divide by 4. So whatever that is will be my answer. So x is 18 divided by 4. 4.5. So x is over 4. I don't have a lot of room. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 4.5 is here. It doesn't look like they're going to intersect, but maybe they will somewhere way over here somewhere. It looks like they do intersect somewhere in the first quadrant. But it's way a ways. Any questions about what I did? I guess they could be parallel, possibly. Actually, no, they're not parallel because the slopes are different. They will intersect. It's just a question of where. Is everybody clear on what I did? Cover up the x to get the y, cover up the y to get the x. It's easy to graph, okay? Now, you know on the PERT test and in Algebra 2 and in geometry, believe it or not, you're going to have to do substitution, okay? So if you learn it, you're going to be covering a lot of things. So on a new sheet of paper, I did not do the second one. Okay, copy this one down. Copy that one down. We're going to do something called substitution. Substitution is where they cross. We want to find out if they cross and where they cross. Okay? It's called the point of intersection. All right, here we go. So take a look. Now look, I know your algebra teacher tried to teach this to you, and you are going to have it in Carnegie next year. All right, so watch. You have to decide which one you want to get by itself. This one has a number. Bad choice. This one has a number. Bad choice. This one has a... Either one of these is okay. I'm going to get X by itself. So circle the X. How do I get X by itself? Subtract Y. So X is going to be equal to X is going to be equal to negative Y minus 4. Circle this and put substitute. You have to be able to do this. Okay, even if you did pass the PERT test, you do need to know how to do it. Now take this and draw an arrow to the X. We're going to substitute. You've seen this before. I tried to teach it to you before. So put 5, open parentheses, and then plug all of this in there. Now see how good your math skills are. But before you do, is there anybody who doesn't understand what I did? You have to get one of them by itself, and then you have to plug it in. You can come up and get the formulas if you need to. Is everybody clear on what I'm doing so far? All right, I want you to distribute and see if you can work it. I'm hoping you can work it, but we'll find out in a minute. All right, here we go. Now, I don't know where you are, okay? You might not be finished, but watch. And I need help here. So what's 5 times a negative y?
Negative 5y.
Negative 5y. What's 5 times a negative 4?
Negative
20. Excellent. I just write the rest of it. Can I combine like terms? Do you see anything I can combine?
Yeah. Negative
5y and negative 3y. Excellent. How much is that?
Negative
8y minus 20. Does anybody know what this equation is called? It's got a name.
Two-step.
It is a two-step. Very good. Why would they call it a two-step? Do you know?
Because you only have to take 2 steps.
All right. What 2 steps? Very good.
You add 20 to negative 4.
What do I do?
Add 20 to negative 4.
I add 20, and then what?
Divide by
negative 8. Very excellent job. Was that a teacher just a moment ago?
Yeah, it was just
Miss who?
Sorry.
All right, so I get 16. Now I divide by negative 8. So I get y equals. What is a positive divided by negative?
Negative
2. All right, so on your answer sheet for PERT, for geometry, for algebra 2, put a negative 2 in the second position. Why would I put a negative 2 in the second position?
You still have another part to the problem.
Okay, and why? Because it's y. It's x and then y. So I used to put them in the wrong spot, so be careful. Okay. Is everybody clear? It's a y. All right, now come on up to the x. See right here where I have x? What does y equal? It's a negative 2, but I already have a negative, so it's going to be a double negative. So what's a negative times a negative? What is 2 minus 4? A negative 2. That is where the lines cross. That's called a solution. Look up here. They cross at negative 2 and negative 2. They cross in the third quadrant. I don't know how they look, but I know they cross right here. And that's all I want to know. Yes?
I don't know how you got x.
All right, look here. A lot of kids, they can find one of them, but they can't find the other one. Okay, that's common. So look up here. You see how I have x right here? All I did was substitute my y, which is negative 2. But I had a negative right here. So a negative times a negative made a positive. And then 2 minus 4, I got more negatives. I have two more negatives. Does that make sense? We're going to try another one, okay? I want you to do this one, substitution. All right? So write this one down, please. And I'm getting them right out of this little book. This is a great little book, by the way. All right, this one right here should be easier because it already has y by itself. So see if you can handle it. I want you to find x and y. Where do they cross? They may not cross, but I want to know. Does anybody know? Some of you are looking at it kind of hard. Well, see, you already have y by itself. So circle this and then substitute. You have to know to do that. I'm not going to be there to tell you. You have to substitute. So you can pick either one. Go ahead and try. I see the other kids, you know, compared to you guys. And, you know, it's no different. Like if I'm coaching a team, I see who maybe needs some work. Some of you know you need some work. You've gotten better. Those of you that passed the PERT test, man, that's amazing. Congratulations. You really need to feel good about that. But you still need to learn more. It's not like you're missing a math person or missing that person. And again, I'm not asking you to like math. I'm not asking you to like me. I'm just asking for you to learn. That's all. That's why we're here. If you end up liking that, good. If you end up liking me, good. But whatever. Bottom line is, you have to try. You gotta try. Make a table, put 0 and 1. You did these, and then substitute 0 and 1 to find the y. All right, about one more minute. Just trying to do some housekeeping and get rid of my papers all over the place.
Are you going anywhere?
Nope.
You'll miss the license? She's going skiing.
Yeah. Actually, I don't like the cold.
She's a big one.
Why, what's the name? We'll see. Remind me about the 6 and we'll see. Look up here now. Watch. In place of this right here, in place of this right here, I'm going to substitute 2x plus 7. But I already have the 5x plus 4. Any questions about what I did so far? Notice that I have all x's. When you do that, you should either have all x's or y's, but no mixture. Okay, so which one's smaller, 2x or 5x? So I'm going to subtract the smaller one. So I get 3x plus 4. This one is called a what again?
Two-step
equation. So what do I do?
Minus 4.
So I get 3. Now what do I do? So x equals
1.
So everybody clear that x is 1. We're all good with that?
Yeah.
Now watch how I do the y. I could go to this one if I want, but I'm going to go to this one. What's 2 times 1?
2.
And what's 2 plus 7? What happens at this point? What happens at that point? The lines intersect. Write that down. You need to know it. At that point is where the lines intersect. That's called a solution. Now look here. What if I got something right here where I have 8 equals 10? It's possible. What if I got 8 equals 10 instead of x equals 1? Anybody? It would be no solution. The lines would be parallel. The lines would be parallel. All right. What if I got something like 8 is equal to 8? That's true. What if I got it and it was true? Then it's the same line. Infinity. They overlap. You've seen this before.
So,
because they would cancel out. And you'd see if you're, like, let's say you have this. Let's say you plug it in and you get 5x plus 2 is equal to 5x minus 4. And then here you subtract 5x from both sides. Now they cancel. So you get 2 equals a negative 4. This would be no solution because the lines are parallel. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
But if they cancel out and it's true, then it means the lines are the same. And they have an infinite number of points. Got it? There's three possibilities. They either are parallel, no solution. They intersect, which is a point like we got here. Or they're the same line, which is an infinite number of solutions. I know your teacher tried to tell you that once before. Might have been a long time ago. Hey, what does 5 to the third power mean? 5 times 5 times 5. Work that problem, please, while I look for some more. Yesterday we were doing percent, so I'm going to give you a couple more of those. So, do I put 15?
No.
It's going to be 5 times 5 times 5. That's 25 times 5 is 125. Is everybody clear on that? All right. I want you to work this one. 75% of what number is 48? If you become a real estate agent, you got to know percentages because that's how you get paid. All right. What was the formula I gave you?
Is over
of equals what? Percentage over 100. Memorize that. Now work that problem. I like percentages. This is really a great formula, whoever came up with this. I'm going to give you 30 more seconds. 30 more seconds. Are we ready? What's my is? My is 48. So put 48 What's my of? 75, that's my percent. See how it says of what number? We don't know what the of is. We do know the percent. Any questions about what I did? That one is a little tricky, so be careful. That's your percentage. You can't say that's your of. All right, so I cross multiply, watch. So I get 100 times that is 4,800. I know that. And then I get X times 75. What am I going to divide by? So which one do I put in the calculator first, the 4,800 or the 75?
4,800.
So it's 4,800 divided by what? My answer on the PERT test will be $64. Is everybody clear on what I did? Maybe, but I'm going to use the formula, all right? Is everybody clear? Do you need another one of these, or you got this down? All right, we got it? All right, I want you to do the quadratic equation. Now, some of you need to memorize it. In fact, all of you do, so don't look at the board, okay? So in your head right now, write down the quadratic equation. I see you looking. Those of you that need the PERT test, you better have that memorized. Better go over that packet, okay? Because I worked them all. You know I did. And I videotaped them. So I get negative B. What else? Plus or minus the square root of B squared 4AC all divided by. So everybody clear? All right, look here. I want you to use the quadratic equation and work out this problem right here. What do I have to identify?
A, B, and C.
A, B, and C. And if I mess up on that, am I going to get it right?
No.
No way. So before you start working, I'm going to do it, the A, B, and C. But I want you to try. So right now, put down what you think the A, the B, and the C is. Do it right now, please. Come on, sir.
You need to talk to him, Michelle, because he's not listening. You understand what I'm saying?
Hurry up. Did you get your hair cut?
No. I got my ears.
Looks good, Tom. You can say thank you whenever you're ready.
Thank you.
All right, what is my A?
No,
but I might need one. Man. What's my B? And what's my C? Look, this one doesn't have an X, so that's why it's this one.
Wait, okay, so the only reason, why is that? Because
you got to memorize this. AX squared plus BX plus C. Write that down. Just write it down. Just write it down. Write it down. Now let me explain it to you. Do you have it down?
Yeah.
All right, look here. You see the X squared? The number with that is my A. There it is right there. The X, do you see an X anywhere?
No.
That's why it's zero. There's no X. There's an X squared, but we already used that one. Got it? And the C stands for the number. That stands for constant. A constant is just a number. Is everybody clear on the A, B, and C? All right, now I want you to plug it in. Try it. Come on, you can do this, all right? Other kids have done it.
Are you trying? Plug it in.
Bless you. One more minute. All right, look up here. Before I work this problem, if you have some friends that you know they need the PERT test, maybe I don't have them. Maybe they're in geometry or something. Because I got some kids, I don't know who they are. But I have packets, okay? And I have video. So look here. This is what I want you to do always. Just like this. And if you don't do it like this, then you're not listening to what I'm asking you to do. And I know I asked you to do that. So everybody clear on the first step. Now you put your numbers in there, okay? And we're certain we got A, B, and C, so let's go ahead. Well, B is 0, so put 0. A is 7, and C is negative 7. And this one is 2 times A. Is everybody with me so far? Well, 0, negative 0 is nothing. And 0 squared is nothing. So get rid of it. So everybody with me? So now you're going to have plus or minus the square root. What's a negative times a negative? What's 7 times 7? What's 49 times 4? What's the square root of 196?
14.
So you're going to get plus or minus 14 over 14. 2 times 7. Is everybody with me? Well, 2 times 7 is 14.
I thought it was
2
times 2 times 2 times 2 times
2. This is 2 times 7. It's 2 times A. It's 2A, not 2 to the 7th power. You with me? All right, so let's do the plus. What's 14 divided by 14? That's an answer. Put a check. Let's do the negative. What's a negative 14 divided by 14? So everybody clear on my solutions? Let me explain what's happening here. This one looks like this. It's a positive. See this A is a positive? That means this one right here is going up. Like this. Let me see. A positive. Let me think now. A negative is going down. So this one's going up like this. And it crosses the x-axis at negative 1 and positive 1. That's how it looks. It's going up. If the A is a negative, it's going down like this. The A determines if it goes up or down. This is called a minimum, the minimum point. You remember I told you the vertex and axis of symmetry? All right, so put vertex. Actually, let's do one more of these, and then I'll go over the vertex. All right, so one more. Quadratic equation, and I'll give you a basic one, okay? So you shouldn't miss this one. So try this one.
Can we get a break at 8:40?
8:45, you can. I'm working too, and I'm only doing that because I got some kids that need to pass. All right, I want you to identify the A, B, and C. I want you to use parentheses. Yeah, I guess so. If you get caught, I didn't let you go. You can do it without getting caught.
Okay. I think I should finish my test.
I think you should have already finished your test. That's, you know, you made a bad choice, and then you're going to say you're not done. I don't know what to tell you. You got to make good decisions.
I'm going to do it.
All right, come on, guys. I really need you to try. And then we're going to do the vertex on this one, and we're going to graph it. I'm telling you, even if you pass, you have to know how to do this stuff.
What?
Just don't want you looking at my head saying onion. That's what I'm feeling. Feeling the burn. A little one. Plug it in. Come on, Dominic. Yeah. Put a 1 in front of that x squared. All right, I'm going to catch up. So A, B, and C. So I get X equals negative B. So negative B, B squared minus 4 times A times C, all divided by 2 times A. Is everybody with me so far? So a negative times a negative is a positive. This is 64 minus 20. I'm almost done. I mean, quadratic equation is not hard, okay? Not when you do it a few times. So I get 8 plus or minus the square root of 44 over 2. The square root of 44, I'm going to do 44 shift square root. So 44 shift square root. I get 6.6. Now watch what I do. I do 6.6 plus 8 divided by 2. 2 times, yeah, 2. So I get 7.3. Put a check. That's one answer. Is everybody clear so far? All right, clear it. Put 6.6 and put a negative in front of it. And then do plus 8 because that's a plus. Plus 8 divided by 2. I get 0.7. Any questions on this? Yes.
How do you switch the negative 8 to a positive?
Well, the formula has a negative, and the B was a negative. So a negative times a negative makes a positive. It's a double negative. One negative with the formula and one negative with the number. Does that make sense? Is everybody clear? All right, let's finish it up. Draw a graph. I do not, sir. All right. Go over 7.3 and put a dot. So 7.3 is about right here. Is everybody clear so far? All right. Go over 0.7. 0.7 is almost 1. Put a dot. Is everybody clear on my x's? Now look here. Put axis of symmetry. We need to find that. Does anybody know what part of this equation is my axis of symmetry? Does anybody know? It's this part right here. It's only the front part. Circle it so you know. Only the front part. How much is 8 divided by 2? So put a 4 right here. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4. Put some lines like this. That's called your axis of symmetry. Put it in that tray, please. Is everybody clear on my axis of symmetry? Look, it should be the same distance here and here, and it looks like it is. Looks pretty good, actually. It's in between. Is everybody clear so far? All right, watch this now. This stuff's not hard. You can do it. Now, substitute this right here. Put it back in here for the x. And you're going to get y. Change that 0 to a y. Put 4 in place of this and this and add it all up, and that'll be your y. Trust me, I know what I'm doing. This works, okay? You got to know it. So what's 4 squared?
16.
What's negative 8 times 4?
-82.
All right, now get your calculator. Add all that up. 16 minus 32. And then plus 5. Make sure you add that 5. Put negative 11. So put 4 and negative 11 and put a V. What does that V stand for?
Vertex.
Very good. All right, look right here. Go over 4, down 11, and put a dot and then graph it. This is called a minimum. Put minimum. That means it's your lowest. Minimum means your lowest. Like somebody says, what's the lowest you'll take? That's your minimum. That you ain't going to go no lower. That's it. You'll find somebody else or you keep it. Is everybody clear on my vertex? Only the front part is your vertex. You got to plug it in to get your y. You got to memorize that. You have to know how to do that. Is everybody clear? All right, now, those of you that got a packet and those of you that need to pass the PERT, tomorrow when you wake up, take a shower, eat breakfast, and start working. Watch the video. There's 10 videos, maybe 11. All right? Good luck when you come back, okay? Because when you click that button, I want you to pass. Have a good break.